It's been a minute, hey. It's been like, I don't know how long it's been. It's been quite a while now, so I don't know if I still have it in me to make these tutorials, but I think I do have it. I think I still have the skill, man. But anyway, yeah, man. So on this video here, what I'll be doing to you for you guys is I'll be showing you guys how to link parameters. So linking parameters is basically just like let's say you have a piece of hardware, let's say you have a MIDI controller or you have something there. And then you wanna use that to do whatever, man. I don't know how to put it to you guys, but like let's put it this way. Let's say I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna open up let me open up this plugin here. You see? So you've got all these knobs, right? So what you wanna do is you want basically linking parameters is just you assigning these things, any of these knobs or these buttons to one of your pieces of hardware, whatever it might be. So, for example, I have a MIDI controller, and then on my MIDI controller, I have a pitch blend and a modulation, right? As you can see, if you look here at the top left corner right here, right? I'm not pressing anything, but I'm gonna move my thing. I'm gonna move my pitch bend thing knob on the MIDI controller, and you can hear it move. I don't know if you guys can hear it, but you can see what's happening. The modulation as well, if I move that, something happens. Basically, that's all you do. So, you're gonna assign a button in your piece of hardware, whatever it might be. MPC, whatever, what do you call this? A MIDI controller. You're gonna assign a button. You're gonna link it with one of these things. So say for example, I wanna be able to, when I move my pitch bend button on thing on my MIDI controller, I want it to actually move this part here, this cutoff point. So that's basically what you're gonna be doing. So what you do is you go to top left corner on any plugin, guys. Any plugin you should have this. Go here. You go to. Go there, go to link parameters, right? Link all parameters like that. And then what's gonna happen is you're gonna choose which one you wanna link. So you wanna choose from here. This is a list of all the parameters that are there on this thing. These are all the buttons that are there, knobs that are here on this silent plugin. So I'm gonna choose the one that I want. Which one is it that I want? I want a cutoff, filter control cutoff, right? So I go here, I'm looking for filter control. It's all like put in order for you. There you go, you got filter A. So you got filter control cutoff right there, right? Got the filter control cutoff. Now it's ready to link, right? Once you've done that, it's basically ready to link. So all you have to do next is just move or touch the knob that you want to link it to. That's all you do. You just touch the knob that you want to link it to. So for example, I want to link it to the pitch bend. So I'm going to touch it just on my MIDI controller like this. And then I'm done. Then I say accept. I think that should work. Let me check. You see what I mean? There you go. So my mouse thing is here now, right? I'll put it here at the side, but look at me moving my thing, my cutoff point. I'm using my thumb on the MIDI controller to move my cutoff point. I don't know if you guys can see this. Let me try and like double record this whole thing so that you guys can see what I'm doing. So basically, yeah. So you're just moving my pitch bend now, and then it's moving both the pitch like on the MIDI controller and on the screen. You can see the cutoff point. And that's all you do. So you're probably wondering, like, when does this actually come in handy, guys? So let me just tell you how when this actually comes in handy. So let's say now you have a song, eh? Let's say you have a song, and let's do this. Let's just quickly add. Let's add this one here, right? And then let's do this. Let's make it. Sorry about that, guys. I forgot I haven't done this yet. It's been a while, man. Yeah. So let's do this. And then we come here, take the volume up a bit, and then let's just do. That should be sufficient, right? I think that's too loud. So let's do it. So you guys can hear how it sounds, right? And then what you're gonna do is gonna do this. So let's say you're working on a song and you wanna hear how this is gonna sound when you increase the cutoff. So instead of having to increase the cutoff yourself manually here, you can just use the button now that you've assigned. So for example, this is playing, right? It's like this. And I'm just gonna move my pitch bend. You see what I mean? Move it up a bit. Basically it. So you can basically just gives you, it allows you to have that physical control over your plugins that you have. So because normally what you have to understand is that plugins were actual hardware before. Back in the days, there was actually like an actual hardware product that you could hold that had all these things, and then you just adjusted yourself physically, right? But now you don't have that. Now you have like a virtual one, which is like the one that you see here. So the silent plugin, it's now virtual, it's on here, and now you have to adjust using a mouse, right? So all you're doing now is basically just having a piece of hardware that you can assign parameters to. So I want to assign the cutoff to this particular button, so that when I press this button, the cutoff moves. I want to assign a particular thing to this particular button, so when I do this, this moves, you understand? And that's going to help you a lot, because cuts down a lot of time, cuts down a lot of things. You don't have to use a lot of automation clips as well. You can just pre-record. You can record things live and then adjust the rise according to you, the way you see fit, you know? So that's basically it, man. That's how you assign parameters. Let you guys let me know what you guys think. If you need more, if you have more questions about it, just let me know. Let me just open up another plugin quick. Let's see. Let's do Hypersonic. See, I'm showing you guys with like external plugins. I'm not showing you with like standard plugins, because that's obvious. So I'm choosing plugins that are like external, so that, you know, in case you do struggle to find it, then that's there. So you go here again, same thing, go here, link all parameters. It's gonna show you all the parameters that have to do with Hypersonic. There you go. All the parameters you might want to link, you choose the one you want to link, and then just assign it to a button on your hardware, piece of hardware, whatever it is, and then you're done. So for example, let me say I'm gonna link the pitch, right? You see the pitch here, I'm supposed to move it using my mouse like that. But if I move the button physically, nothing's happening. So let me link the pitch to my actual MIDI controller button. Because look, you see everything else is linked, just these buttons are not linked. So let me just try and do that quick so you guys can see one more time how it's done. You go to that bottom arrow, link parameters. We're looking for pitch, right? So come here, where's the pitch? Try and find pitch. Just find the pitch thing here. It should be somewhere here. I don't know where. I think that could that be it? I don't know, actually. Hey, it's a bit of a tricky one, but it should be that one there. I've got a feeling it's this one here. Let's see. Should we try this one out? Let's try this one out and see. Okay, let's say accept. Okay, it's an absolute knob. I don't know where the absolute knob is. Which one is that? But yeah. So let's try and see if you can't find the pitch. But that's basically the gist, man. So you just link whatever it is that you want to that. So, okay, let's try this one. What if it's this one here? Is it working? No, it's not. Okay, I don't know why it's not working. I think I'm choosing the wrong things. Probably somewhere else. But you just find the right one and then link it in, and then you're done. So that's how it works. That's how you link parameters. Hopefully, you guys found this tutorial very helpful. I mean, I've got more coming along, more tutorials I want to be working on for you guys. I think there's a lot of channels now where they teach you guys how to make music and all those things. So I probably won't focus too much on making genres, different types of genres and stuff. I'll probably just focus on things like these, like linking parameters and the nitty-gritty stuff that you guys might not know, but could actually come in handy for you. And this works for everything, guys. It's not just the MIDI controller only, you know. You can have any piece of hardware, so long as it has buttons, you can link that particular button to something on the software, you know. And then you just have a physical control, or physical touch, or physical sense of things. It's almost like, the best way to put it is like, imagine Virtual DJ. Most of you know Virtual DJ, right? And then you know how to use a mouse to mix a song and everything else. But now imagine that you had an actual CDJ and whatnot that was linked to Virtual DJ, and then whenever you touch the volume, it gets adjusted on Virtual DJ. So that's basically what you're doing with linking parameters. You're just linking certain parts of this plugin to an actual physical instrument that you can actually control using your hands, so that it makes it easier for you as well. And that's basically it, man. So yeah, like, subscribe, comment, Facebook, Twitter, SoundCloud, follow, all that jazz there. Yeah, man. And then I'm sorry, just to apologize to you guys. I know it's been a long time. I've been promising to make videos and stuff, and I've been lazy. partly because of laziness, partly because I started working, I got a job, so you know, morning work, come back afternoon, you're tired, and then you think I have to make a video for this, editing, opening up the software, all those things, you know, it's just you end up getting lazy. So that's basically what happened, man. You know, no excuses. I'm just being straight up honest with you guys. But I want to try and, you know, balance things out here and then maybe make a video or two every now and again. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this, guys. Like, subscribe, comment, Facebook, Twitter, SoundCloud. Follow all the Jesse. Shep, shep, profit.